وهو حي دائم لا يموت أبدا بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير صلاة وتسليما يليقان بمقام أمير الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وأستاذنا مصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول تبارك وتعالى في كتاب العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله من النار رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي أما بعد My dear respected brother in Islam, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, peace and salutation to our beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As today we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again to give us good health, to be in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we know, this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a name from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is our brother and our sister, they are lying in hospital. And there is our brother and our sister, now there is preparation for them to take in the graveyard, the destination for them forever. They are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to say alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, as we still alive and we have to follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brother, today inshallah, I would like to share with you my khutbah, the way last khutbah, last Jummah we were speaking regarding the Masjid al-Aqsa, the history about Masjid al-Aqsa. So today, inshallah, again, I would like to share with you to know the blessing about the Masjid al-Aqsa. Because we found it now many Muslims, they're speaking about Masjid al-Aqsa. And the way we remind ourselves last week, there was many brothers, they asked some questions regarding different ulama, why Masjid al-Aqsa every day there is fighting, why Allah could not give them Nusra. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran, you can be good Muslim, but there is test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the key for today, to remind ourselves regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Muslim, to getting the way we can say, call up and to remember, to know what the benefit, what the blessing about Masjid al-Aqsa. This is to remind ourselves, maybe, one day you meet somebody to ask about regarding Masjid so you can know the benefit and the blessing about Masjid al-Aqsa. Today, inshallah, I would like to share one hadith from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرًا تَوْفَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ is to remind ourselves regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we get the benefit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Jumhuri ulama mentioned about Masjid al-Aqsa, we know in the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even not the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the seerah of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, is him who built the Masjid al-Haram in Makkah al-Mukarramah, today we call Kaaba. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam immigrated in Madinah al-Munawwara. Allah directed, Ya Rasulallah, be near to the place so you can build the Masjid, now we call Masjid al-Nabawi in Madinah al-Munawwara. So this is Muhajirina wal-Answar. People from Makkah, they migrate in Medina, then those will be Sahaba from Makkah and the Sahaba from Medina. So we call Muhajirin wal Answar. So this is to show the foundation, how Masjid Aqsa come from. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was one Sahaba, Abu Dhar al-Ghafari, asked Ya Rasulallah, I want to know in three masjids for the moment, which masjid was the first to build Masjid? Nabi sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem said, Abu Dhar, the first masjid was Masjid al-Haram, Masjid al-Makkah. Baytul Haram called Makkah. That was the first masjid to build. Then Abu Dhar asked, Ya Rasulullah, which was the next masjid? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied to Abu Dhar of the Fari radiallahu anhu, say, Ya Abu Dhar, the second masjid was Masjid al-Aqsa. This was the second masjid to build in the world, Masjid al-Aqsa. So the foundation of this masjid, my dear brother in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned last week, he mentioned Surah Isra in verse number 1. That I was trying to remind, if you go to your house, try to read the Quran. You will see how Allah described Masjid al-Aqsa in the Quran. So this is what the blessing, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the Muslim name about Masjid al-Aqsa. The ulama mentioned we have to know the meaning Masjid al-Aqsa. There is different three names. Some ulama, they say there is four names, but I would like to share with you two names. And this is Jumuhur ulama, they mentioned in hadith, as Imam Muslim and Imam Bukhari in hadith, authentic hadith, they mentioned Masjid al-Aqsa. There is two names. And then number three, that's why we are using always Jerusalem, we say Jerusalem, the whole place. So number one, Masjid al-Aqsa. The meaning of Masjid al-Aqsa is father's masjid, is father's masjid. That is the first meaning, the meaning of Masjid al-Aqsa. The second meaning about Masjid al-Aqsa, there is ulama they mentioned Masjid al-Aqsa and Masjid al-Muqaddas. This, there is two different names, but it's looking the same. But the tafsir about this name, there is difference. Masjid al-Aqsa, father's masjid. The ulama, they mentioned, they call father's masjid because masjid from Makkah and Medina, they are too close. But in Palestina, it's far from Makkah and from Medina. That's why they call father's masjid. So this is like we would like to say, to remind the people, and where we say like, regarding the masjid, to know Masjid al-Aqsa is benefit for us Muslim, as Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the time, he was not happy, he wanted to conquer Masjid al-Haram and Masjid al-Aqsa. All the time Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to remind the Sahaba, we have to conquer Masjid al-Aqsa. The second, the meaning of Masjid al-Aqsa is al-Masjid al-Muqaddas, the holy place. The masjid is pure, the masjid is holy, according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way ulama says, al-masjid al-haram wal-masjid al-aqsa. The way Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he moved from Makkah to Palestine. Then in the same Palestine, there was two skulls from Palestine to heaven, to Miraj. That's why ulama they say, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Masjid al-Aqsa in the Quran to show this is the benefit for Muslim. And there is many, many blessings, my dear brother in Islam. The second blessing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was the key to gather all the prophets in one place, all the prophets in the world. There was only one place in Masjid al-Aqsa. From Nabi Adam alayhi salam to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all them, they gathering and they make two rak'ah on that Masjid al-Aqsa. So this is to show the blessing for the masjid. And number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as ulama they mentioned in the Quran, that there will be the destination for the day of judgment will be Masjid al-Aqsa. So brother Islam, they ask Sheikh, what is the reward if you pray in Masjid al-Aqsa? If you pray in Masjid al-Aqsa, what will be the reward extra? As we give example here, brother, if you pray here, we get the reward for Salat al-Jumah. But in Masjid al-Aqsa, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was asked Abu Sahaba, Abu Dhar al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu, say, Ya Rasulullah, what is the reward if you are praying in the Masjid al-Haram in Makkah? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the reward is 100,000 extra reward to pray in Masjid al-Aqsa, in Masjid al-Haram. Then he asked, Ya Rasulullah, what will be the next? The reward in Masjid al-Aqsa. The ulama here, they mention here, if you pray in Masjid al-Aqsa, there is opinion ulama, they say you have reward extra for 500 salah extra. Look, my dear brother in Islam, look the benefit to be inside in the Masjid al-Aqsa. It's like you are praying in Drohida, Allah reward you 500 extra salah in Masjid al-Aqsa. Then they ask, Ya Rasulullah, what will be next in Masjid al-Nabawi? Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in my masjid, if you pray, you get reward for 1,000 salah extra. That is a reward for Masjid al-Nabawi. So my dear brother and my dear brother in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Masjid al-Aqsa in Quran. There is more wisdom Allah to remind us and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to remind us to visit these three masjids. Well, when we are going in Mecca, we are going in Medina, but Masjid al-Aqsa, Asir al-Masjid, is that is not free. And it's a sunnah for Muslim to visit this masjid because you have reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the way ulama mentioned, if you go in Mecca, you go in Medina, as well you have to travel in Masjid al-Aqsa. So this is to remind ourselves, and the way you plan, you do your holiday, but one day inshallah, make dua Allah to make easy for you, to make your holiday to go for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Masjid al-Aqsa. Amen. There is more reward if you enter that masjid, 500 salah extra, my dear brother. This is the name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us in the Quran. Plan and make your holiday, my holiday this year I'm going in the Masjid al-Aqsa to pray on that house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be praying when Nabi Adam alayhi salatu was in the masjid. You will be praying with all prophet that was inside of that Masjid al-Aqsa. Then there is more blessing on that masjid, my dear brother Islam. Number four, you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the land of prophets. The land of prophet, all the prophets come from there. That's why we mention Nabi Ibrahim, Nabi Musa, Nabi Ilyas, all the prophets come from that land. That's why we call Masjid al-Aqsa. This is the masjid Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recommend us to visit this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they ask, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I want to know what was the next from Masjid al-Haram and Masjid al-Aqsa. Which was the masjid to build the first? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it was Masjid al-Haram. Then how long, how the distance from Masjid al-Haram, from Masjid al-Aqsa? Which the distance, how, what time they was building this masjid, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Masjid al-Haram, the distance from Masjid al-Aqsa, there is a distance for 40 years to build in the Masjid al-Aqsa. That's what they got. 40 years from Masjid al-Haram and from Masjid al-Aqsa. So there is hadith. Ulama mentioned here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to mention on this hadith is to show how there was God from Masjid al-Haram in Masjid al-Aqsa. There was 40 years to build the Masjid al-Aqsa. That's why the Jumuhul Ulama they mentioned here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always recommend Muslim to build the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He himself, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to Masjid al-Aqsa and he was imam for all the prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is to show the key and the blessing for the house of Allah, Masjid al-Aqsa. My dear brother in Islam, wallahi, this is a house, is not free. That's why the ulama, they call Hasir, the masjid is not free. This is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned again, when you have something, light the house of Allah, Masjid al-Aqsa. You have one, you have to donate the house to get light in this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many rewards when you are going inside of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My dear brother, there is more blessing. You cannot finish for one khutbah into khutbah. Maybe I have to take five khutbah to finish the blessing of the Masjid al-Aqsa. The ulama mentioned here, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, this is a house in Mecca and there is a house in Palestine. To show some brother, they think this is not our problem. And if you can read the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to call Baytullah, the piece of house. This is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the time for Roman Empire, they used to call Elia Shalom in Hebrew. They used to call Elia Shalom. And if you can see in the hadith, Imam Muslim, they call Elia, there is in the hadith, they call this Masjid al-Aqsa Elia because the Empire Roma, when they called the masjid, they changed the name. So they want the name to change, but Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remind the Sahaba this will be Masjid al-Aqsa all the time because this is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentioned the Surah Isra, ila al-Masjid al-Haram, ila al-Masjid al-Aqsa. This is to show, my dear brother, we are speaking about Masjid in Mecca, Masjid in Medina, but this Masjid we have to feel something in our hearts. The Masjid is not free. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He need to give nusra for this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the masjid can be free and Muslim they can live in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is blessing all around in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one in Intel Masjid al-Aqsa, all around. All earth will be blessing for the Masjid al-Aqsa. This is to remind my brother and my sister, regarding Masjid al-Aqsa, there is many hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as the way Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the one who has power, he can live in Medina and he can die in Medina. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommend again, visit the Masjid al-Aqsa. Make dua on the Masjid al-Aqsa. You will get reward for 500 extra. This is to show the benefit of the house Masjid al-Aqsa. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make easy for us. Amen. Insha'Allah, Allah to give us good health so we can visit the house of Allah Masjid al-Aqsa. أقول قولي هذا فاستغفروه فإن الله هو الغفور الرحيم وهو التواب الرحيم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله ولي الصالحين والصلاة والسلام على أمير الأنبياء سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, would like to remind ourselves regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brother in Islam, this is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Inna Deena Inda Allahi Islam. We have the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to sign the deen of Allah is Islam. We have to follow the Kitabullah. We have to follow the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And those people, they come after Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so we can get the way to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is to remind myself and to remind you regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just have small paper, write your amal, my dear brother. Are you praying 5 times? Just put in your paper. Are you give shadaqah? Just put in your paper. Are you trying to help different people regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Then tick yourself, this is good for me. If it's not good, wallahi, try to work hard to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran. بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمُ وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. Allah to remind us to feel the day will be. Return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The day will be in straight for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show everything you did on this dunya. If you was praying 5 salah, Allah show you the good amal. If you could not help, Allah show you your amal could not help in this dunya. So this is to remind ourselves regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the way we say last week, our salah, that will be number one in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the key for every Muslim ibadah. As-salatu imaduddin, I will remind last week, our ibadah, my dear brother in Islam, that is the key in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can give sadaqah, but if you don't have ibadah, still nothing. You can fast in Ramadan, if you don't have ibadah, still nothing. You can go for Hajj and Umrah, but your key is your ibadah. That Allah to take this, alhamdulillah, my brother was praying, so-and-so, this is the reward for you. Even the grave, number one, they will ask you, amal, your ibadah. So this is to remind our salah, this is number one, to communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Jumhur ulama, they say, if we can check the number for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is 2 Fajr time, is 4 Dhuhr time, is 4 Asr time, is 3 Maghrib time, is 4 again Isha time. This is the call for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time will be Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. That will be Fajr time. Then Zuhr time, you'll be communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, astaghfirullah. Then Asr time, you'll be communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is to show you get the word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On daily basis, you are connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To show this is the amal Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind you. Then to get connection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then wallahi, don't forget to make dua for people from Palestine. This is, we don't have money, but the key number one, dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we answer your dua regarding those people in Palestine. I saw one teacher last week in Palestine. There was one young boy, 7 years.
He said, because I read in the Quran, Surah Israel, this is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was speaking to the soldier from Israel. He said, I'm ready to die because of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until this house will be free, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For us, we cannot give him 5 euros regarding the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brother Allah, think the day we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, we ask you, was walking on this dunya, but you could not even think about people that suffer regarding my house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will be the question, try to prepare on this day of Yawmul Qiyamah. Allah, we ask you, I give you name, I was listening different lecture regarding the Masjid al-Aqsa. You could not even to say, Allah, ya Allah, I have to donate for this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we are planning our holiday to go somewhere else. But this is the house of Allah. People, they are crying for the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Donate for house of Allah, my dear brother. You will get reward in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Jumuhul Ulama says, when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be time you are crying, Ya Rabbi, I need to go back to do even 1 euro for sadaqah. To pray even 2 rakah in the masjid. They say, time is finished. Too late. That you cry, you say, Kala Rabbi Rijawoni, Kala Rabbi Rijawoni, and time finish. So this is to remind myself and to remind my brother Islam. Wallahi, we have to communicate with our maker is Allah. Allah who look after our sweetha, Allah who look after our business, Allah who look after your family, Allah who look even you are driving in the road, Allah who look after you. Who look after you is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then you forget your maker Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember this Allah we ask you, I give siha. There was people in hospital, they are lying in hospital, they could not even make salah. But I give you chance to come in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You forget to make dua for those people that suffer. This is the key, my brother. We have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make easy for us. Then we can get the way to make dua for those people in Palestine. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make easy for us. You can make dua for all Muslims that suffer in the world. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us good siha so we can get the way to remember Allah all the time. Inna Allah wa malaikata yusalluna ala nabi ya ayu alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alamin innaka hamidu majid. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين آمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين آمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين واذل النفاق والمنافقين واذل البدعه والمبتدعين اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وبسوارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عدانا انصرنا على من عدانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.